pick out an animal to show. If I'm looking for a heifer, I look for a feminine animal, kind of a nice slim neck and nice looking head. You don't want it too broad or anything. You want nice straight lines, straight legs. You don't want it to be cow-hocked or bow-legged or anything like that. You want them to be sound. That's probably the most important thing. I always hear judges say they start from the ground and work up on an animal. You want a good disposition. That's very important. You don't want to be getting run over or drug around the ring or anything. I feed my show heifers a 12% sweet feed. Sometimes I add cottonseed hulls or corn that kind of bulks them up a little bit or drops their stomach down. Gives them a little bit more spring of rib, that's important. Hay also has kind of the same effect. It'll kind of fill out their stomach and make them look very good for show day. Well, I start by grooming, brushing the animal off before I even bathe them because it will remove any kind of loose debris like straw or leaves. Then I wash the animal. I always kind of keep the hair moving forward and up, and so I do the same thing with the water. You have to get them thoroughly wet, soaked, so that the soap will actually work. Then you put soap in the hair. I chose to do this by putting the soap into the water stream so that it sprays all over the calf. After I put the soap in, I rinse them out again, work the hair up and forward. And after all the soap's out, it's very important to get all the soap out because it creates dandruff. And then you blow them dry. I start at the back because I'll get the hair dry and then move on to the next section of wet hair. If you start at the front, I feel like you blow the hair dry, but then as you move back, you blow wet hair over top of it. So I feel it's important to make sure that all the hair is dry. After I finish blowing them out, I comb them and make sure kind of there's no damp spots or anything and get all the hair moving where it's supposed to be. And then I'll spray in some conditioner, comb it in, and then blow dry again. Just kind of once over real quick, hit any spots that you might have missed. After you blow the conditioner into the hair, you can fit, if you're allowed to do so at the show, pull the leg hair and spray the adhesive and kind of get all the hair working, standing up straight. To get ready for show, you do that. Put maybe some shine spray in their hair and some final bloom to make the hair pop and shine. A lot of work at home is very important. You have to start with having a broke animal to learn how to show. I always like to start when they're kind of right after they're weaned, so they're kind of big. They weigh probably 600 pounds. So I always like to try to get a halter on them before I give them any feed, after they're used to me, because the feed is kind of a reward. So if I put the halter on, I've always had pretty good luck with just tying them, letting them feed. So once they start walking, you just have to walk them, just keep them moving. Sometimes it takes a little bit of a push or a shove. You just gotta keep them moving and keep them going. So once they learn how to do that, you just practice. You walk them in circles. You make sure that you're setting them up. When you stop, you want their front legs to be next to each other. You don't want one in front or one behind, but you don't also want them touching. They need to be kind of evenly spread. The back legs, I like to profile, which means the leg on my side will be a step or two ahead of the leg on the outside, and they'll be straight, standing up well. And you just have to practice so that the heifer knows how to stop or where to stand and everything. And after you do this for a couple weeks before the show day shouldn't be a problem. You have a stick to help you set up their feet. The stick doesn't need to be too long that you have to hold it in the middle to reach, but it doesn't need to be so short that you have to lean down under your heifer to move your feet around. You really shouldn't need to use it too much. You should practice a lot at home so that it kind of happens naturally, but it's there if you need it. And also while you're walking, you can kind of stick it out in front and stop them, slow them down if you need to. Pace is very important in the ring. You have to make sure you're not running, but you also don't want to drag around. Go at the pace that complements your animal. I usually take long strides because I have long legs and my heifers have long legs, so we take longer strides and then we kind of slow down to stop and set up. So that's how you go into there. And showmanship, to me, this is the most important class. I take the most pride in winning this class because it's based on the showman instead of the animal. Of course, you want your animal to be clean and look nice, but it's not based on conformation. You have to present the animal yourself. You have to do it well. The judge, I think, is very impressed when you can answer questions quickly, correctly. When you know everything about your animal, you always want to look at the judge, make eye contact, smile, look like you're having a good time. Move around the animal so that the judge can always have a clear view of your animal. So if they walk up behind you, just kind of step to the side, make sure that they can see. It's very important that you do well in showmanship to kind of put yourself out there and make yourself look better.